Hi, welcome back. As promised, here's the comparison between the Ecovacs T8 AIVI and the Roborock S6 MaxV. So both these robots have AI and a front-mounted camera, enabling each one to avoid obstacles. But which robot vacuum is better at such, and which is the better option overall? I'll answer these questions and more, so let's get started. First, we'll look at the obvious, which is how well these robots avoid objects. The Ecovacs T8 AIVI and the Roborock S6 MaxV are the only two robots I know of with a front-mounted camera for obstacle avoidance. Ecovacs has a single-lens camera, while the S6 MaxV has two lenses. This camera is paired with artificial intelligence that informs the robot when it has to evade an object. The question is, how effective is it? I've done a lot of tests, and the results were mixed at best. While both can avoid objects, it has to approach them at the right angle to detect and avoid them. Otherwise, the obstacle will fall into the camera's blind spot. Once the objects are in these blind spots, the robot will not avoid them. Roborock has gone through several firmware updates to fine-tune its algorithm. But the technology isn't perfect. There will be instances where it hits the obstacles. If you're thinking about running any of these robots with pet feces around, it won't be a good idea. Roborock's upcoming product, the S7, doesn't have a front-facing camera, while Ecovacs' other T8 options uses lasers instead of a camera, so I don't know if the trend will continue. Overall, Roborock's twin-lens system and more frequent updates give it a slight edge over the T8. For instance, it was better at avoiding objects at the edges. It even avoided the weighing scale that's below the minimum height threshold, whereas the T8 did not. Both robots have similar navigational qualities, starting the run cleaning the edges before moving towards the middle. One difference is the option for Roborock to do an extra pass, which may come in handy if you need a little more thorough clean. Otherwise, the two passes for Ecovacs is enough in most instances. These robots did well in the coverage test, picking up nearly all the quicker oats I scattered in this area, except for spots it didn't fit. You can see that both have the same cleaning pattern, so there's not much difference between these robots with navigation. Both are excellent at navigating through tight quarters. Not once did these vacuums get lost or stuck in this maze. But you'll have to tidy up those loose wires. Even with a front-facing camera, this is an important task to eliminate any risk of the robot not completing the cleaning cycle. Invisible wall, no-go zones, and no-map zones are available for both robots. You can add as many as needed in each map level. I believe these are essential features every smart robot vacuum should have, as most homes have off-limit spaces. Map saving is also available for both, but Roborock's app can save more, up to 4, versus the 2 in the Ecovacs app. Surprisingly, the T8 has more power than the S6 MaxV with around 23 CFM at the max setting versus the S6 MaxV's highest at 15.68 CFM. The superior airflow is noticeable in the sand on hard floor test, where the T8 picked up more sand during the initial passes. However, the S6 MaxV picked up more eventually because it has a third pass and the Ecovacs twin side brushes scattered more sand. This was also true with the other tests, as the single side brush of the S6 MaxV scattered less debris. It's less of an issue on carpet as fibers add more friction, so debris don't scatter as much. However, Ecovacs dual brushes give it the edge for edge cleaning. It did much better in this area, picking up more debris. The S6 MaxV didn't do as well and left much more dirt behind. Roborock has the advantage with cleaning hair. It picked up more 5 and 7 inch strands than Ecovacs, despite the latter having more airflow. The denser brushes could be a factor why it picked up more. Another advantage for Roborock is the easier to clean main brush since both end caps come off, whereas Ecovacs does not. The S6 MaxV is better at cleaning carpet, both surface and embedded dirt. One reason is the main brush. If you look closely, the S6 MaxV's bristles are denser and stiffer than the T8 brush that's on the softer side. Another reason is the lack of a third pass, which is a bigger deal on carpet than it is on hard surfaces. Roborock picked up more in the deep cleaning tests with a 77.65% score versus the T8 that only picked up 66.65%. both robots have similar dustbin placements at the top. I like that the Ecovacs bin has a mesh filter, preventing particles of dust and debris from building up on the folds of the filter. The Roborock dustbin doesn't have this mesh, so there will be a buildup on the filter's creases. While the S6 MaxV has a larger dustbin at 460 ml, the T8 has the auto-empty system, which is sold separately. So this negates the capacity advantage Roborock has. Both robots have an electronic water tank, so each double as a robot mop. Roborock has a slightly larger water tank with a 297 milliliter capacity versus the T8's 240 ml capacity. Another difference is how you attach the mopping pad. The S6 MaxV's pad has these latches on both sides, so it easily slides in from the back. The T8 doesn't have these latches, so you'll have to flip the robot over to attach or remove the water tank. To test how well each robot mops dried stains, I left red wine droplets overnight to dry. Roborock did much better, leaving less residue and a cleaner surface afterward. The T8 didn't do as well and left more red wine residue and visible tire marks. Ecovacs sells the upgraded Osmo Pro mopping system with a vibrating feature that should remove stains better. It's a similar design to the Roborock S7 mop, but the difference is you don't have to buy another robot since this accessory is compatible with the AIVI model. There isn't much of a difference between the Ecovacs and Roborock apps. Both have live maps, providing real-time information to users of the robot's location, battery life, and potential issues. Map saving is available for both, unlocking advanced navigational features like selective room cleaning, zone cleaning, invisible wall, no-go zones, and no-map zones. Both have carpet boost so that users can leave it at a lower setting and the robot will automatically increase suction when it detects carpet. However, Ecovacs uses a different terminology for this feature. There are a few differences. First is the number of maps. Ecovacs can save up to 2, while Roborock can save up to 4 map levels. Next is the number of passes. The S6 MaxV can do up to 3 passes, while Ecovacs does only 2. The Roborock app has the option to name rooms, and it works with Alexa. Ecovacs does not have a custom room naming feature, so you're limited to a predefined list. Roborock also makes it easier to access the front-facing camera since it's within the main interface. This feature is useful if you want to see what the robot sees if you're not home. Ecovacs has a similar feature, but users won't have access to it from the main interface. Lastly, Ecovacs has the auto-empty feature where a second vacuum in the auto-empty station empties the dustbin's contents for you, but you'll have to purchase the auto-empty station separately. The T8 is slightly noisier with up to 67.1 decibels at the max setting than the S6 MaxV with a max of 65 decibels based on the sound meter test. Both robots utilize a 5200 mAh lithium-ion battery and will run for up to 180 minutes, so both are great even for large homes. The T8's runtime is more impressive though, considering it has higher airflow even at the standard power setting. Runtime should not be an issue for these robot vacuums, as both have recharge and resume, so these robots will resume cleaning automatically if it doesn't finish previously. To conclude this comparison, I'd give the slight edge to the Roborock S6 MaxV as it has better obstacle avoidance, mopping, and cleaning performance, especially on carpet because of the denser bristles. One advantage the T8 has is the availability of the auto-empty bin, but that is a hefty premium on top of the robot vacuum cost. If you have any questions about these robot vacuums, please leave them in the comments below. Like, subscribe, and tap on the bell icon if this video has been helpful to you. Links are in the description for more information. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.